Good evening, everybody. Welcome to Samuel Stadium, home of the Inland Empire 66ers baseball team, the Angels minor league team. I would like to thank everybody for attending the 7th annual Austin Gorrell Memorial Classic. What a great weekend of baseball we've had. I would like to thank Toyota Redlands for donating the field for the championship game. First, I'd like to congratulate our two teams that are playing tonight with Aquinas and Norco. Good luck, boys. Play hard. Next, I'd like to introduce Carrie Gorrell.
Hello. Thank you guys for coming out and spending the first week of Thanksgiving with us. I want to thank the Bells, the Campbells. With this group right here, it would never happen. People ask us how big our committee is. It's right there. 84 games our first day, put on by them. It's a ton of work, but it's worth it. See the look of these kids' faces. Every table that you went to, every game you went to, we had a table there selling gear. And that was all of our family, friends, people that knew Austin, played with Austin, but they've all become our family now. They're all right down here in the left field line. Give a round of applause, would you? That's all our family. And this year, for the first time, we pushed the social media a little bit. So we had Alicia Schneck, it's my niece, who ran our social media for us, and it was great. So Alyssa, thank you. Where's she at? Oh, she's right there. Alyssa, thank you. Thank you again. Happy Thanksgiving, and thank you for coming out with us.
Now I'd like to introduce Gina Gorrell, Austin's mom.
I would never get receiving that dreaded call at 5 a.m. from the doctor telling me that Austin has passed. It changed my life forever. But through Austin's death, a lot of good has come out of it. Look at how big this great tournament has grown and the over $25,000 we have given out in scholarships. He is truly changing kids' lives. Austin loved the game of baseball. He showed that every time he stepped up onto the field, and he will always be ready to give it his all. He never complained about the early workouts of the games, long drives, or any injuries he was sustained on the field. I used to call him Cracker, because his ankles would crack as he walked up the stairs at our house. But after all that, he was always prepared to do it all over again the next day. So tonight, we honor our strength again and play this great game like he would. And his legacy will forever live on. To all those dedicated here tonight, go out there and play this game like Austin would, because you never know when it will be your last. Thank you to this incredible baseball family that we love so much. I would especially like to thank my husband, Carrie, my son, Adam, the Trudells and Campbell family for making this tournament even possible. Also, huge thank yous go out to our family and friends who are always there for us. Thank you for coming tonight. We love you all.
Thank you, Gina. We started this tournament 7 years ago, not knowing where it would go. Started with 8 teams, and now we've increased our numbers to a max of 40, and Gina pushed it to 42 this year. to compete at a chance to play under the lights at a beautiful venue. We have been told this is an elite tournament to end with fall ball. We have donated over $125,000 in Austin's name, helping graduating seniors for college expenses. Tonight we will be giving out $33,000 to 10 participating seniors. For those who have never got a chance to meet Austin, you sure missed out. A fierce competitor on the field, a loving, kind man with a smile that would brighten a room off the field. He set a goal to play Division I baseball and achieve that goal, committing to play at Reno, Nevada. After a physical, Austin was diagnosed with cardiomyopathy. Even though he was unable to play, he loved the game and decided to stay at Reno to continue to be a part of the team, go to practices, and the weight room. It was after diagnosed, Austin posted his famous quote on September 1st, 2015. "Don't take this game for granted. We blow it off like this game will never end for us someday. I have learned that it can happen." On October 10th, 2015, Austin gained his wings. Austin is dearly missed by his family and friends, and we are honored to continue his legacy. Our first guest speaker tonight is one of Austin's best friends growing up and current assistant baseball coach at Vanguard University, Cameron Trudell.
Hello. Like you said, my name is Cameron Trudell. Once again, I want to say thank you for all you guys to come out here. The support we get from the community this time, every single year, really means a lot to myself and to the Gorrell family, so thank you. Austin and I became friends at a very young age. We grew up in Arupa Valley. That's where we first became friends. We attended El Camino Real Elementary School, and we played for Arupa Pony, and that's where we've really bonded, is on the baseball field. We were both undersized middle infielders and didn't have the arm to play shortstop yet. So we found ourselves working on the same thing and in the same drills at practice. From there, both of our families decided to move to Orange Crest, and that's when our friendship became a brotherhood. We went to the same elementary school again, but we went home together every single day. It was our responsibility as the older ones in the brotherhood to get Adam after class and walk home to the Gorrell household, which wasn't too far from Ben Franklin Elementary. There, Gina was my second mom and my teacher. She was all over us in the classroom. Austin was a much more disciplined student than myself, and he led that way by example, and she was right there holding my hand through it all. So I appreciate you getting me through those classes. But after we finished our homework, it was time to play. It was me and Austin playing knee football on the carpet while Adam was our ref. We would go outside and play football together with the other kids in the neighborhood, and that's where we connected again. It was our passion to play and compete. Austin was a fierce competitor with a big heart. You would see that big smile on the face, whether it was on the fields playing football or it was playing baseball, and you saw the fire of his hair, the wavy hair flowing throughout the field, coming out of the back of his helmet on the football field or on the baseball field out of that skull cap that he would wear. That skull cap made him famous. He would wear it on the baseball field and on the football field. Like I said, Austin was a fierce competitor, and that's what I see when this tournament goes on. It's grown to 42 teams, and we compete every fall for this. And tonight, you guys have a chance to compete in his name. And I just ask that you guys leave everything on this field, because one day it could get taken from you. Just play like your hair is on fire, just like Austin Gorrell would, and that's all that we ask. I appreciate all the support from the community and everybody here tonight. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Cameron. Our second guest speaker tonight is longtime head coach of the CB Lancers, Gary Adcock.
I'm showing my age. He has it on the phone. I have it on a clipboard. I don't know if I'm not techie or not, but I appreciate the chance to speak with you. Congratulations to both teams and all the people that are about to receive those scholarships. I first met Austin when he came to one of our youth camps. You remember the camp, the very first one we had, you came one of the 30 people we had at that camp, and I saw the passion and energy he played with on that day. As a coach, and there's a lot of coaches here, I see you here, every year we kind of reflect on our season, what we did wrong, what we did right, what we need to do well the next year. This is a big year at CBU. We finally have the chance to go to the postseason, so my reflection was quick, and I came up with three absolutes that our team has to do. And in thinking about what to share with you tonight, I thought, man, Austin did all three of those things. And he accomplished all three of those things. So I will be brief, but I'm going to give you three things that I believe exemplify his life and that will benefit you as well. First one is trust. You know, I ask our team to trust. And trust defined is a confident expectation in something or someone of whom which someone relies upon. And the Bible tells us, you know, to trust him and trust the Lord and not trust other things, outside influences that are negative or things that might deter you from your goals. And if you trust your teammate, you build a self-cohesion, and now that team's great. I can't think of a word that describes Austin better than trust. He trusted the process, he trusted his teammates, and he enjoyed the game. The second thing I asked my team to do was I asked them to play with a confidence, but a belief that exceeds that confidence. I saw that in Austin as well. I tell a story to my teams every time before we go to the playoffs. If I put a 2x4 board on the ground here and I ask all these players to walk it, they can do it in no second. They could walk across it, they would be confident they could do that. If I stretch that board above, up there between those light standards, all of a sudden fear creeps in. And now they start thinking I might fall. And players that play feared or afraid, they lose their confidence. Because confidence is an emotion. But players that trust in their preparation and build their confidence through that preparation start to believe over trust. Austin believed that he was a Division I baseball player. You have heard that from people. In fact, he told us no in the recruiting process because we weren't Division I. He wanted to play Division I baseball, and he prepared to that point to make that dream happen. I'm going to close with a quick story. In 1981, my parents took me to a movie, Chariots of Fire. Now, there's probably only 10% of the people in here that have seen that movie. You have to be over 50 like me. But in that movie, it was about a Scottish missionary named Eric Liddell, who was also a runner. Now, Eric's family didn't want him to run. They thought that he just needed to be a missionary. And instead, he told them, God made me for a purpose, but he also made me fast. So he went against his parents' wishes, and he continued to run and made the Olympics. But then his heat for his Olympic race was on a Sunday. So he said, my religious convictions, I can't play on Sunday. So he wasn't going to race in the Olympics. All that work that he had put into it, he just wasn't going to do it. One of his teammates felt so bad for him. He said, hey, you could race in my race, which was not a race that Eric typically ran. It was a 400-meter race. And as the story goes on the starting line, one of the American runners handed him a verse saying that that those who honor God, God will honor. And as the story goes, he ends up winning the medal and reaching or impacting more people for the gospel than he ever would had he not run. In everything we do, I tell our teams, you need to praise and honor God. I can't think of a life more well-lived than Austin and more people that have been impacted by it. Jackie Robinson said, a life is not as important as its impact on others. Man, that Austin's life has impacted so many. And look at this. So players, trust. Have a belief over confidence. Praise and honor God with what you do. And enjoy this evening. Thank you.
Tonight, a player from the championship game will be awarded a small scholarship and a plaque for Cody Smith will be the Strong Man Award, and Matt Becerra, the Always Humble, Loyal, and Respectful Award. Cody, one of Austin's friends and played football with him, lost his battle to cancer in 2014, and Matt Becerra participated in the Austin Gorrell Tournament in 2018, and unfortunately that would be the last tournament he played, as he was killed in a car accident in January 2019. Now I will turn it over to Graham Campbell, and he will announce the scholarships.
Well, first of all, thank you everybody for coming out and attending this special event, special evening. So each year we have this tournament and we raise funds through, you know, a few different ways. First off, the entry fees from all the teams, donations from around the community, from businesses and individuals, sales of all the Austin merchandise that's at each of the host sites, and basically after all our costs, that's what's left to get away in these scholarships. So a huge thank you to all the sponsors and all the people that donated and bought their gear and made this possible. Wouldn't be possible without any of you, so thank you. So this is our seventh tournament, and prior to tonight, we've given out 51 scholarships totaling $125,000. And tonight, we've got 10 scholarship recipients, that's a total of $33,000. So last night, when we were deciding where we were at with the money and how much we have in scholarships, it was around $30,000. And then we had another donation that came in that basically bumped us up to $33,000, which was Austin's number. So that's why we opted that we have to do $33,000. And that'll bring us to a grand total of $158,000 over these seven tournaments. So pretty remarkable. So this year we received about 60 essays. About 60. And we always joke that if it was completely up to Gina, all 60 of them would get about $30 or whatever it would divvy up to, because that's just the kind of person Gina is. But like I said, we've got 10 recipients down here, and the way that we kind of go through the process, we get all the essays, we read them with a group of family and friends, and split them up, reread them again, split them up, reread them again. So we put it through a process. It's not just a 10-minute thing. It's a two-night, many hour thing that we go through. And then there's tears every year. So I think that's about it. We can get into the scholarship recipients. So we got the checks there. Got them ready? All right. First up, from Murrieta Valley High School, Noah Benavides, the scholarship for $1,500. Hey guys, if you want to walk down a little closer so you don't have a huge walk. So next up, from Vista Murrieta, Willis Lacey with a scholarship for $2,000. Next up, from King High School, Mason Swan with a scholarship for $2,500. Next up, from Great Oak High School, Ryan Lee, with a scholarship for $2,500. Next up, from JW North High School, Luca Noce, with a scholarship for $2,500. Next up, from Great Oak High School, Brendan Shanahan, with a scholarship for $3,000. Next up, from King High School, Austin Castillo, with a scholarship for $3,000. Next up, from North High School, Jacob Ariano, with a scholarship for $4,000. Next up, from Pauley High School, Mason Schumacher, with a scholarship for $5,000. Not least, Jack O'Malley from Cream Lutheran with a scholarship for $7,000. So again, guys, thank you for writing those essays. You're all the guys that are here tonight that are in the tournament. That's a lot of money right there. So you guys are seniors. Make sure you're writing those essays and get them in. And hopefully we'll see you guys out there as well. There's Billy Trudell again. Congratulations to the scholarship recipients. And I ask everybody to please rise while Lexi Mercadefi will sing the national anthem for us.
Oh, say can broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. O'er the ramparts we watch were so gallantly streaming, and the wreckage fragger, the walls bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still
Now we'll have the first pitch thrown out by one of Austin's great buddies, Sailor Strain. And the catcher will be Mikey Lara. He was a recipient and one of our committee members. Mikey is wearing Austin's glove that he received from Reno, Nevada. Now Cash Matson will give the player's prayer.
I ask that all of you bow your heads for the athlete's prayer. Lord, please clear my head of all distractions and my heart of all burdens I may bear, so I may perform my very best, knowing you'll always be there. Please lift me up before the moment, so through your eyes I may see and have a clear understanding as the game unfolds before me. With great courage, I will meet this challenge as you would have me to, but keep me humble and remind me that my strength comes from knowing you. Then, when all eyes are upon me at the end of this game, I will turn their eyes to you, O Lord, and to the glory of your name. Amen.
Thank you, everybody. The game will get underway shortly.
number 21, Ryan Jenkins. Hitting in the 8th spot, number 11, Jason Bondini. And hitting last, number 4, Robert Dilatori. And now the lineups for Aquinas. Leading off, number 6, Landon Young. Hitting 2nd, number 10, Eric Bitonti. Hitting 3rd, number 24, Nathan Christman. Hitting 4th, number 25, Seth Rajak. Hitting 5th, number 9, Mason Greenhouse. And hitting 6th, number 99, Owen Hegan. Hitting 7th, Esteban Olazawa. And hitting 9th, Chase Davidson.